Well, hello, you bearded bastards, and welcome back once again to Milpcast, Waddlesquash. Right now it is the 13th of Granite, 407, early spring of our fifth year here, I believe. 5 years, that's a pretty big landmark right there. And just looking around us, I can easily say we've done it, pumpkins. We've created for ourselves a nice little settlement out here. Really excellent work. Now, let's see, what's going on right now? Well, you may notice that we've completed those four structures we had just planned up. Houses for our new citizens, the glassmaker, woodburner, asher, and clothier. And we've also planned up two additional structures down to the south. Houses for our new mason and smith. So at this point, all of our residents are pretty well taken care of in terms of housing. Or they're going to be shortly anyways. That being said, there are still some additional touches that we do have to add on to our little settlement here. Our two strangeling friends don't yet have houses, Mendulp and Chang. Each of those guys has their own room over in the Bent Limb Inn. And that's, I mean, it's fairly serviceable anyways. They don't seem to mind quite yet. Plus, I mean, when you get down to it, they're not, like, full citizens yet. They're kind of just loosely affiliated with us. We'll wait for them to decide to make things more permanent before committing more housing to them. Also, I mean, just from the looks of it, they've stolen an awful lot of clothing from our pumpkins. Notice it just strewn across the floors in here. Yeah, they seem to really enjoy tattered clothing for some reason. Couple of raggedy strangelings, those two. Anyways, there is another house we have to make too that I only just realized. Man, the guy is so soft-spoken. I wish he would have said something. Whiten, our leader, doesn't yet have his own house. He was the first one to get a bedroom in the upstairs of our meeting hall right at the beginning, and that's where he's been sleeping ever since. He does not yet have his own dining room or office or anything like that, and so we're gonna have to come up with something for the guy. That's really gotta get done. So after we're done with these two houses down here, we're definitely gonna get to work on that. It's impressive the guy has gone this long without proper housing, or a proper office for that matter, just considering the amount of management he's had to do around here. I mean, look at all these work orders. He's in charge of all this. You can see here we have a whole bunch of clothing slated to be made. We've already started in on that. Gonna make some bags too for collection of sand. Got some new wooden furniture on the way, as well as ash, potash, pearl ash, and charcoal. Now, our simple math scales out here aren't too good, but I think this here will be enough to get us 300 windows. But I suppose time will tell. We will have windows soon, I promise. And then maybe we can also start producing some glass crafts too for these poor strangelings, who every year come to trade and we don't have a blessed thing for them. Kudos to them, but there's just not much we could do. Now then, as for Whiten's new house, having a look at our old meeting hall here, well, this is our current meeting hall for the pumpkins. Remember, we have a meeting hall here because we thought maybe that open tavern would be a little bit more dangerous with all the outsiders coming in and out, you know. But it's really not bad at all. There's been an awful lot of people in here. Strangelings, humans, bogeys, exploding specters, everything. And there hasn't been a single sign of trouble anywhere. So, that being the case, I'm thinking maybe we make the Bent Limb Inn our main meeting hall. It should work out fairly well, as it has been. And that being the case, how about we just kind of enlarge our old meeting hall? Make it into a proper house for Whiten. Yeah, I mean, we could do something like this right here. Just add a spot off the back, and we'll continue it up to enlarge this whole upstairs area. Yeah, that'd work just fine. Of course, down underneath is our food storage, the main food storage for Waddlesquash, so maybe we'll have to think of something else. Not gonna want people walking in and out all day long looking for food. That might get annoying. Now then, having a look over here to the west, we can see the humans of Hindtown have arrived to trade once more, meaning that summer has arrived. We're working our way straight through this year, aren't we? Yeah, we're gonna try to do some real trading this time around. We haven't been doing a lot of trading recently, so it's probably for the best. We could use some more metal bars, that's for darn sure. Stone too, if they've brought any. And a variety of food never hurts either. Yeah, we'll see what we could do. Well, this is a strange notification right here. The human spearman, Beryl Fatimosmi, was spotted sneaking around, and upon being spotted, screamed, "I'll live to fight another day." They're over here in the northwest. They're pretty much right behind our barn. And just glancing at this person, they look to be quite the heavy hitter. Fully armed, classic soldier's garb, lots of bronze. They are extremely well armed. And they're also carrying a deadly looking spear. They're marked as hostile, and they do not appear to be running away either. I don't know what the hell their goal is, but I'm willing to bet our pumpkins will not be able to hold up against that spear. That being the case, I've already ordered them to be holed up in a building, away from this threat, and I suppose we can hope they just run away, eventually. Or, you know what? They're heading behind our barn, and someone with a gun could easily shoot through this fortification over here, the pumpkin pen. I've ordered Whiten to come over. Yeah, the guy is kind of just running back there. He might be trying to escape, but doesn't really look like it. Whiten is moving in and is now in the pasture. Yeah, he's just sitting behind that fortification there, armed with his blunderbuss. And unfortunately, he still has wooden shot for it. So I don't think he's going to be able to do much damage, but I guess you never know. Regardless, it looks like the guy is running off a bit, but might be coming back. Oh, Whiten took a shot, but the guy is running away. Yeah. Okay, this was a horrible mistake. Whiten has jumped the fence. I forgot how spirited the guy is, I guess. He jumped the pasture fence and has run out here up to the spearman, who looks to be fairly wounded now. Whiten is just unloading shot into the guy. I could call off the attack, but this guy is a threat, right? But if he gets up with that spear, Whiten might be a goner. Let's just see what happens here. Yeah, that guy is down and out and is dead. Whiten was able to fight the guy off. Oh my god, that was so good. Whiten, look at you with the blunderbuss. Man, that was brutal right there. Uncharacteristically brutal. But wow, when it comes to defending his settlement, Whiten can do the trick. Man, oh man. Yeah, it looks like he knocked the guy down on the ground, just unloaded all of his shots into him, and then when he was out, he ran up, pulled the guy's helmet off, and just started whacking him in the head with his blunderbuss, and that's how he put him down. Man, that was really something. Good job, Whiten. Waddlesquash is safe. And just having a look at this fallen human, they've dropped an awful lot of good things. Got an iron breastplate, bronze boots, bronze gauntlets, a bronze mail shirt, and some bronze chain leggings. Cool, you know, I guess it shouldn't be out of the question to maybe get Whiten armed up a little better. First off, I should say I'm a bit shocked that this even happened. I don't know the reason for it. Oh, you know what, I guess while we're discussing this, we should probably let the pumpkins out of the church, too. They're just holed up in here praying. This is the worst threat to have ever come to Waddlesquash. Go ahead, you guys, get out. Go back to work. We're safe now. Whiten has defended us. And yeah, let's shake it off. Shake it off, pumpkins. We have plenty of work to do still. Just keep on your toes, please. And I suppose before anything else, we should do some trading with these humans here. We've kept them waiting for a while now, haven't we? Yeah, let's take a second to wind down by doing some trading, and then we'll do a bit of a deeper reassessment of those events. Okay, well, as you can see, we do have quite a bit to trade, including a lot of tattered clothing. And you know what? We're going to mark it all for trading, too. Every single bit of it. That gives us quite a bit to play around with. And so, we will take a whole bunch of stuff. They got some stone blocks we'll take. And you know, they do have a bunch of metal goods, too. I'm thinking maybe we should take some of that and just melt it down in our forges. The cheaper stuff, anyways. It'd be nice to have access to some metals. Maybe we can make some more potent rounds instead of that wooden stuff that Whiten's been using. I think that'd be perfectly in order. Looks like they have some additional drinks here. Good stuff. Tomato wine. Haven't had that before. Give it a try. Get some more bags for sand. Sure, why not? A whole variety of meats and fish. Can't go wrong there. And you know what? How about we spoil ourselves with some cheese this time? That's a luxury we've not yet had here in Waddlesquash. And you know what? How about we get some parchment sheets, too? Maybe someone in the library would want to do some writing. You never can tell. Gotta be worth a shot, right? Anyways, yeah, I think that's gonna about do it. The traders are ecstatic. Excellent. Good doing business with you. And we hope to do more next year, my friends. Now then, we're done with trading. And we do have some interesting information about this recent startling event. That's right. If you have a look here, I didn't notice this before the event. It says here, the Catling poet, Chang Cliververge, has revealed the presence of Field, the wise will tell, to the human spearman Beryl Faitumusme, which is that human attacker there. Now, Chang Cliververge is one of the strangelings that we just recently took in, remember? I'm not too sure what to make of this event right here. It says they revealed information about a book that we apparently had in our library, that I imagine was dropped off by one of those exploding specters, and it seems like this spearman was looking for the book. Maybe follow the specter here, and Chang, who does spend a lot of time in the library, kind of passed the information along. I don't know if Chang was getting something out of this deal, though. The guy may have just mentioned it, not thinking. Go figure, too. Something like this would happen right after we were saying how safe it is in here. There were a few other humans in here as well, carrying weapons. I don't know where they went or if they're affiliated with that spearman, but we're going to have to keep our eyes open for future thieves. And we're definitely going to be keeping eyes on Chang over here. I have a feeling the guy just kind of innocently passed along the information, not thinking. He'd have no reason to think that human would cause trouble like that. Just, keep some tighter lips there, Cat. We'd all appreciate it. Now, on the subject of catlings, we actually just received another petition from this individual right here. Her name is Rans, and she's a scholar. This is very interesting. We don't have any proper scholars here in Waddlesquash, and we do already have two troublemaking strangelings here, though Rans seems to be a little bit better put together, I'd say. And so I guess I was thinking that maybe we could take her in as well, give her a room in the bent limb. What the heck, right? Might as well, it's just one more individual. Hopefully it couldn't hurt. Let's give it a try. You are approved, Rans. Welcome to Waddlesquash. But yes, things have settled down a little bit at this point, so let's have a little look around, see what everyone's up to. If you have a look, these two north houses are looking pretty darn good. These two houses here are going to be for Salmon the Glassmaker on the right, and Ansi the Asher over on the left there. And then down this way here to the south, we have four more houses, two of which you haven't even seen. The ones up to the north are for Scord the Woodburner over on the left, and Cass the Clothier's house is over on the right. And those two squat southern houses there, those are for Rin the Smith and Hans the Mason. Plenty of storage out front for stone and metal bars. I figured that'd be apt. If we have a look up, the second floors are almost all completed on all four of these buildings. Having more pumpkins around has really, really helped in this process. We only really just started. Oh right, and over here too, at our meeting hall, intended to be Whiten's new house. Bottom floor is all done, and if we have a look up, that's getting there too. Actually starting to run out of wood. Gonna have to go around and cut down a whole heck of a lot more trees. We are burning through it. Literally, too, in many cases. Ash and charcoal and whatnot. Anyways, having our pumpkins holed up in our church over here got me to thinking. Well, first off, I should mention that our church is now completely outfitted with some nice new statues, a brass altar, and a few bits of additional storage, too. But yes, the pumpkins, while they were in here praying to Mengfor, really got me looking at some of these statues. The statue in here is brass and shows Mengfor, and Mengfor is raising up a slab known as the Embraces of Joy. This statue here relates to the creation of the slab by Mengfor. Now, I have to imagine this was a rather holy event to the pumpkins, in the entirety of the beige denomination, actually. I personally don't yet know much about this slab, so it's hard to say what part it plays in the religion itself. But yes, I imagine it's pretty important. Okay. This sums it up. The Embraces of Joy is a copper slab. All craftsmanship is of the highest quality. And on the slab is engraved the Secrets of Witchcraft. Very interesting. Makes you wonder where it is. I don't know where the thing is. Might be that we have a book on the subject. We could probably look through the little pumpkin library and see. Yeah, by the way, this is all of our books these days. And if we scroll down a bit, yeah. You can see it's quite a bit. Not sure how many there are now, but it's over 200. I really wasn't kidding about the number of specters exploding around Waddlesquash. It's quite a bit, but yes, we could certainly have a look through. There's gotta be information in one of these, right? I'll let you know if we find anything. Well, I have spent a whole bunch of time looking through these books, and I have yet to find anything about that slab at all. Or Mengfor, for that matter. Kind of a shame. I will keep my eyes open, but yeah, haven't seen anything yet. We do get enough books here where one's bound to show up eventually, right? For now, though, we have to get back to work. Well, if you have a look here, we are working our way through our clothing. We've already made quite a few sets. By the end of the year, we'll have enough clothes for everyone, for sure. Our slated furniture is almost done, and our ash, potash, pearl ash, and charcoal are coming along. Pretty impressive, actually. Yeah, getting some more pumpkins and Waddlesquash was a really good idea. Things are just moving so much faster now. Real nice to have that work spread out a bit. Hey, would you look here? It looks like another thieving strangeling has popped up. Haven't seen one of them in a while. Oh, it looks like two of them, actually. Wait, three. Troublemakers. Well, Whiten's on his way already with his blunderbuss, but I don't think he's going to catch up to him. This is the first time they've come back since we beat up that other one, the Batling. Maybe they're starting to get desperate, and that's why they're coming back. I'd have to imagine that's the case. Little dummies. Yeah, they're out of here. Sorry, Whiten. No action today, it looks like. I still can't believe how savage this guy was in that attack. Very spirited. Blasted that human away, ripped his helmet off. Very cool. Quick little update on the guy. He's doing very well. He's still in a relationship with Pastor Chur, but they haven't really gone too far with the whole thing yet. I was kind of hoping they'd get married at some point, but again, even now there really hasn't been all that much downtime. It'll happen at some point. Mainly just have to get these new houses done. And after that, we'll have a nice long rest. Eager to see if we'll have any relationships form after that. Here's hoping. Well, moving on a bit, if we have a look over here at the Trade Depot, we've just finished up trading with the pumpkins for this year. And we've got some pretty interesting things, too. We were able to get a whole bunch of steel items this year. All kinds of stuff, too. Armor, weapons. The pumpkins usually bring a random assortment, which we don't have much need of, typically. But I figured we could grab a whole bunch and just start melting it down. We traded away a bunch of the stuff that the Spectres have dropped off at our borders. Instruments and various crafts. We've kind of been collecting it up. And our hope is that we can make something pretty cool for White in using the steel we traded it for. We'll melt down what we got and make the guy a proper suit of armor. Something a bit more suitable for the protector of our small settlement here. Just in case he gets into another scrape like that last one. Gotta protect the guy. Looking up to our north, you can see we have a catling thief who's skulking about behind our barn. I should really start addressing this one by its name. This is Volate, Catling. They're the first one who showed up, and they're also that one that Whiten chased around a whole bunch. Remember that one? One and the same. Little troublemaker. I think right now it's just panicking, trying to get away. Now, why don't you look over here? A battling thief. Sirieri. I believe this is that one that Whiten actually caught up to and shot all those wooden blunderbuss balls into. And then it went crawling off back into the forest. Remember that? Yeah, they're some really bad thieves. As you may well have realized. They've yet to steal a single thing. Really, at this point, we're not even worried about scaring them off anymore. They haven't been any trouble at all. They don't have any weapons or armor, and I don't even know what they're doing. I think they're just trying to spook us. Have fun, you little creeps. We're not too concerned about you anymore. Looks like we've run into some trouble over here in the east. Glur the Woodsman just knocked down a tree, ugly. I don't know if it collapsed on top of him, or what exactly, but yeah, that was not a clean cut. Not too sure what causes that sort of thing, but just like Antsy last year, he seems to have walked off just fine, not even missing a limb. These pumpkins are pretty tough, I suppose. Again, taking note of that. Anyways, having a look here at the date, it appears to be the 20th of Granite 408, early spring, of our 6th year here. Quite impressive. Like, truly, too. Look how busy this place is. Just an extremely well-put-together little settlement we have here. Things are really turning out great here in Waddlesquash. Now, we got a little distracted there for a second. But remember, I was talking about melting down some of that metal stuff that we traded the humans for, or pumpkins? We got them from a trade somewhere, and we have been busily melting them down left and right. And if you look here, you can see we have a bit of iron, gold, silver, copper, bronze, brass, steel. Yes, a whole bunch of useful metal, and some expensive ones too. I'd like at some point to start putting some more niceties in our people's homes. Maybe after we get windows sorted out, huh? But for now, yes, I think we should work on some sort of protection for Whiten. And as such, we have Rin the Smith over here forging away. We did actually trade for a few useful bits for Whiten already. He has a really nice helmet, and some gauntlets too. But the guy still needs a mail shirt, some greaves, and boots as well. But yeah, he's almost there. And while the rest of those pieces get sorted out, how about we have ourselves a little look over here, where we can see Whiten's house. And you can see it's looking rather nice, isn't it? Here on the bottom floor, you can see our former meeting hall. It's now converted into a dining room. Over in the back there, you can see a little sitting room. It's his office, pretty much, a study. In both rooms, we have a lot of food storage, some cabinets, and chests. He has an armor and weapon rack in his study. You'll notice, too, that we moved the basement entrance outside, and now there's just kind of an open cellarway, just because I still don't know what to do about that food in the basement. One of the most important touches you may have noticed already, though, is that he has a bunch of windows in his house. Isn't that cool? 8 clear glass windows down here on the bottom level. Man, I'll tell you, it's really good to get some of those in place. We're starting to pump them out. Before long, I'm hoping to have maybe 100 of them after all our work orders are complete, but I suppose we'll see what happens. I doubt that's even going to get us as far as we want to go with windows. Might need 2 or 3 times that, but now that we have all our major buildings completed, shouldn't be much of a problem. I might even assign some of the other pumpkins to window crafting duties, just to help speed things along a little bit, you know? And yes, I'll show you the upstairs too. Whiten's personal quarters, just kind of L-shaped, fairly narrow, but still spacious. Nice little sitting area up there, some bookshelves, 2 more windows. There's a total of 10 clear glass windows in here, so yeah. This is currently one of the most well-appointed places in town. And actually, I just realized that we have enough left over where we can get the church fully outfitted with windows as well. So we're going to get 10 of them installed down here on the ground floor. Mengfor's house should be properly well-appointed. You can only do so much with wood and scant metal. But windows? That right there is an exquisite touch. It's good to finally get the Lord's house outfitted like this. In fact, it's good to get all of Waddlesquash outfitted like this. Finally, our town's really starting to come together. And it's about darn time, isn't it? And with that, we're going to start talking about some behind-the-scenes things. Well, that right there was a very productive episode, wasn't it? Had a whole bunch of stuff happen, some interesting things too. Actually, you know what, first and foremost. Whiten killed that adventurer guy, the one that was looking for that book. That was so cool. I thought for sure Whiten was going to be dead meat, especially when I saw, like, I didn't notice right when he jumped over that fence, only when he was, like, a couple feet away. And at that point, I really thought the guy was a goner, but turns out he must have got pretty lucky. Lucky enough he had that, the skill he's been practicing with his blunderbuss for a bit beforehand. And I really think he must have got lucky with hitting him a couple times. Knocked the guy down on the ground, knocked him unconscious even. And that right there did a trick. Actually, normally when I play these episodes, you know, we fight forgotten beasts and you're knocking those things down left and right, no big deal. This here, though, had a much different feel to it, didn't it? Yeah, certainly a bit harrowing. Glad to see the guy pull through right there. That's one of those, like, rare Dwarf Fortress moments you don't often get, where something unbelievable happens. Personally, I know I've said it in the past, but I think it'd be really cool if Waddlesquash evolved to the point where it was like a town and we had a militia, and maybe just like a little squad of riflemen or something. Musketeers, I suppose. But we'll see what happens. I think next episode we're going to focus on making some more housing. Just maybe smaller houses. Maybe even some, like, combined houses. Duplexes and stuff. Right now we only have the 15 people in town, and the settlement's pretty sprawling. So if we're going to want to fit more people in the future, then yeah, we're going to have to start shrinking the houses a tiny bit. I'm sure it'll go fine. Something else I would like to mention is that, like, I haven't mentioned it yet, because when the series started, it was, calm, pleasant. I didn't really want to get into, like, you know, war and conquering and all that sort of stuff. This is a small settlement, and I'd like for it to maintain that feel. But things are happening outside of our little home here. We've gotten news a couple times, and I haven't really paid attention to it, because, really, I didn't think this series would go on this long. But, right now, the Autumn Kingdom here is in the Age of R, and R is a devil. As this world progressed in creation, it started off in the Age of R, and then, like 100 years in, moved to the Age of Two Devils, and then back to the Age of R, and then once again back to the Age of Two Devils, and now we're in the Age of R again. I don't know where this second devil kept coming from. I poked around in Legends a little bit. I forget what I saw, though. Like, this was back in the beginning, but, like, R was there from the beginning, and at two other points, a second devil popped up, but was killed or dispatched or something. But R has remained through it all, and his armies have been marching, like, all around us and conquering everything. So I don't think we're in necessarily a very safe spot here. Well, I mean, I should say we are safe now as long as we keep our population small enough, so it shouldn't be that much of a problem. I'm not concerned about it. We got a good thing going here, after all. Waddlesquash. A perfect little home for little pumpkin heads. Anyways, let's wrap it up for now. I hope you enjoyed yourselves today, and I certainly do hope to see you next time here in Milpagust, Waddlesquash. And until then, you bearded bastards.